Hello everybody and a very warm welcome to Krasnoyarsk 2019, the 29th Winter Universiad, and we're at the Sopka Cluster at the Winter Sports Academy for the freestyle skiing and two finals for you today. It is the ski slopestyle final for the women and the men. A fantastic view looking around the outskirts of Krasnoyarsk. Beautiful setting for this Winter Universiad Games. Freestyle skiers have been waiting a couple of days, but now they are finally about to decide their medals. And we start with the ladies' ski slopestyle, the first of two runs for you, and the best run will count. Judges are looking for five things: progression, amplitude, variety, execution, and difficulty, and we'll take you through those as we go. Execution is takeoff, control, slides on the rails, landing and grabs, and difficulty, just the whole look of the run. Here are the weather conditions for you, just below freezing, partly cloudy. I would say it's cloudy, the sun trying to shine through, but no shadows on the snow at all. And the blue dye just helps the athletes differentiate on the landing. And here is the course profile for the ski slopestyle, and the important numbers there at the bottom. The number of features: two big jumps and two jibbing features, which includes the likes of rails or a pyramid or a ball, anything in which they can show off a different style of their skiing. To go, here is the start list for this ladies ski slopestyle final. Just the six athletes taking part, four from Russia, one from Estonia, one from France, and they will go in reverse order from qualification. So the ladies ski slopestyle final about to get underway, and the first athlete to ski will be Anastasia Sivchenkova from Russia, and she will go into the first of the jibbing sections along the rail. Didn't quite go all the way to the end of the rail. Really important that the athlete goes all the way to the end of the rail. That's much better going without goggles. It shows you the light now through the jibbing section, and here comes the big first aerial, and she goes to the left, just a 360 with the grab. Now will she go the other way, just to check on the speed? She goes to the right, 360 with a cross grab, and lands it, and she has her first clean run. Sivchenkova 55.80 in her qualifier. Well, she's bettered that, 64.2. Caroline Holter from the University of Tartu in Estonia. Holter to the first rail. Better than previously seen, and rides all the way to the end of the second rail. Comes skiers left for the next rail, and the switch off it coming into the first jump switch. There's switch 180. And come into the second front way, shave some of the speed off. And we'll go to her left, and it was a 720, a double rotation to her left, but she didn't stick the landing, and she will be marked down on that. But it was definitely more technical, 56.80, so marked down because of that mislanding. Bib number three is Lou Barin of France, from the University Savoie Mont Blanc in Chambéry. 77.8 in qualification. What can she do here? Won a Europa Cup in La Clusaz in France in February. Into the first arc. Haven't seen anybody use that before. She looks confident, and that's a beautiful it was almost a beautiful dismount off the second rail, and a lovely 5.40 off the third and final rail. Coming in switch, we'll pull a 5.40 rotation off the first jump. Shaves some of the speed as she comes into the second and goes to her left. It's a great run from Barin. And the French team enjoy that one. That surely is our new leading run. Change of direction on the first. Great dismount off the rail. There is the 5.40 rotation having come in switch. And didn't quite make the grab on the second air, but I think that should be good enough for the lead. It is 74.8 for Barin of France. Bib number two is Lana Vosakova. Now she won the Youth Olympic Winter Games in Norway in 2016. She's come first at the national championships in Russia 2016, 2017, 2018. And a great record behind her. Takes on the first round, the spin dismount, adding to the difficulty. Then comes skiers left to take on the second round. Another little three-quarter dismount. Comes in switch and doesn't quite make it count on the third rail. Here is the first aerial. And it's a left 5.40 with the grab coming into the second switch. And she will go to her right with the corkscrew. That's a wonderful run, and no wonder she lifts her hands above her head. Great run from Vosakova. No wonder she smiles. First rail was well ridden. The second rail was also well ridden. Third one not so good. Spots the landing, comes in switch, and there's the double corkscrew. Getting the head round nice and early. Good landing. 87 on the nose, and that is better than her qualification run of 85.2. Good work. Bib number one, Anastasia Vitalina from Russia. Runner-up at the Junior Ski World Championships in August of last year. Second at the National Russian Championships the last 2 years behind her teammate Lana Vosakova, who's in this competition as well and currently leading the way. Vitalina into the first of the jib rails. Nice, oh no! A disastrous start for Tatalina. Going down off the first jib, and the skier who led qualification, this is now just a sighter for the second run. There's no safety net now for Tatalina. Comes into the first kicker, goes left. Nicely done, the 720 with the cross grab. And now spins the other way with the corkscrew, 900 off the second jump. But it's all for nothing because of the error off the first jib rail. Little out of breath as you would expect, but here's the error. Just get her skis caught. How frustrating for her. But after that, she skied it pretty well. And her rotations were big, there was lots of amplitude, the execution was good, the difficulty was good, and there was variety. But the error on the first rail, and that means she scores just 7. Russia. Shukilova, 20 years of age. Mm. 49 on the first run. Got to let it all out now here, Louis.
Yeah, she's got to go for broke. She came off a little bit early on that first rail, but she's still got loads of features to show her style and impress the judges.
Moves skiers left to take on the third rail.
Better on the down rail, just cuts her speed on the way out, though.
Here comes the first jump. And you go and pulls the backflip, almost over-rotates, does over-rotate, and she's down and out.
Said she had to go for broke. That's exactly what we saw.
So, real disappointment for Shakirova. Actually got too much amplitude and over-rotated.
Yeah, it's a super quick course. You'll see the skiers throughout qualification, or for myself anyway, constantly having to check their speed on the way through. It's a big, big course as well.
She will finish no better than fifth. Two runs, best run goes towards your final position. So, bib number one, Anastasia Tatalina of Russia, the last athlete to go in this ladies slopestyle final. Got a 7 on the first run when she blew out. She needs 64.2 to get on the podium, or 87 or better to take gold.
She's going to be feeling the pressure for sure, but if there's someone in this lineup that can do this, it's going to be Tatalina. Just checking the speed early on.
Nice from Tatalina, that's
really
much better.
Good. Really good on the rails.
And gets the rotation on the rail, didn't quite ride it to the end. Coming to the first jump, what's she going to pull here?
She has to make sure she completes this one.
She pulls the 720. Now she'll have to go the other way here. And the 900 off the second jump, is it good enough? 87 is the magic score for gold for Tatalina.
Go with a 720 and a 900, stomp the landings after a little bit of an inconsistent rails period.
Well, Prusakova, who currently leads, has beaten her at the national championships in Russia in 2016, 2017 and 2018. And can she finally get one over on her compatriot?
It's not the perfect run. The grabs are off a little bit early, but she showed good intent in the air as well. It's going to be close.
It's surely good enough for a medal. Tatalina goes second, 84.6. And in doing so, knocks Sivachenkova off the podium and Lubava down into bronze. But Russia take the top two medals in the ladies' ski slopestyle final. Confirmation then of the final result of the ladies' ski slopestyle final. And Lana Prusakova of Russia takes the gold with her first run score of 87. Anastasia Tatalina gets into silver medal with a good second run. And Lou Barin of France takes the bronze. Start list then for the men's ski slopestyle final. And Yaroslav Kuznetsov of Russia will get us underway. 12 competitors from 7 different countries: Russia, Slovenia, France, Switzerland, Great Britain, Germany and Finland all represented, and the athletes going in reverse order to their qualification results. So Daniel Antel of Finland had the best score in qualification, an 88.6 in his first run, 1 point more than Yona Schmidhalter. Bib number 5, Dmitry Mulindayev.
Okay, you can go.
Mulindayev, 22 years of age. Second at the national championships in Russia in 2016 and in 2018. Has some performances on the Europa Cup. Now, let's have a look here. Goes inverted over the first rail. Comes in. Comes off switch. Onto the pyramid. Like he came off a little early, coming in, switched to this first big kicker. The line rotation off the first. Oh, the 1260 off the last kicker. And that's a good run from Mulindayev. 75.4. He goes into the lead. Bib 10, Tobias Müller, the Ludwig Maximilian University of Munich. 23 years of age. Second at the Austrian National Championships in Kaplun back in 2017 in Austria. Müller. A lovely final rail. Now coming in switch to this first kicker. A 2.5-9 rotation. Nicely done off the final kicker. He enjoyed that one, as did his teammates. Let's have another look. Neatly done, but for me, his final kicker was the best. There's the 9 off the first kicker. And the German goes top. 92, that's an excellent score. That's the highest score we've seen today, including qualification. No wonder he's smiling. Elliot Gory from the University of Savoie Mont Blanc in Chambéry, France. The next challenge qualified third with a run of 86.8. That came in his first run. What can Gory do here? Well, he's coming in switch to this feature skier's right. The 270 on to that one, 90 on, then the 1.25 rotation off. Nicely performed. Nicely executed, coming in switch. That's a massive jump off the first kicker. Gory looking to impress with his final jump. Oh, he stomps the landing, and Gory punches the air in delight as he lays down a marker in his first run. And that was just for starters, because this was the main course from Gory, and he stomps the landing. That is brilliant, but is it good enough to beat 92? Must be, you would think. What's the sensitivity to us? 89.2 for Gory goes into second place, just behind Müller of Germany. Number 21, Jona Schmidhalter from the University of Freiburg in Switzerland, 87.6 on his first run. The 87.6 coming qualification into the second rail, coming at it very quickly, just takes on Ulaika. Taps him on the head for good measure. Here's the first jump coming in switch. And does the 720 off the first, coming in switch again. He'll have to go the other way this time. He does go the other way and lands it. 1080 on the final jump from Schmidhalter. I think that one's more of a safety, and he'll go for broke on the second. Here's the second aerial. That's more like it. He'll need something like that on both jumps in the second run, but the Swiss fans enjoy it. And Schmidhalter, 85.2, goes into third place. Daniel Antal from the Hanken School of Economics in Helsinki, 22 years of age, won the Finnish National Championships in Rukka in 2017, as well as the Europa Cup event in St. Anton, Austria in 2016. Goes skiers right for the feature there. Now comes across all the way to the other side, onto the rail. A little 270 off, 90 on, and a good spin off. Now coming in, switch to the first of the jumps. chose a 9 with a good grab. Here comes the next one. And there is a great final jump from the athlete who won qualification with a score of 88.6. But is that good enough to beat or overtake Muller, who leads the way with 92? 82.2 though, not enough to get him onto 20. The podium. Ooh. Work to do for Antel.
Yeah.
Yaroslav Kuznetsov of Russia will get us underway in this second run of the Ski Slopestyle Men's Final with a score of 23.4 in the first run.
Absolutely nothing to lose for the Russian here. Second feature, first one, really good form on the top two features, holding the rails for long. That's a good turn off the last feature, coming into the first one, switch.
And comes in, going forward, so that's 540 with the rotation. Oh, he went for broke and holds his head. Now, did he smack his head on landing? It looked like he did, but let's hope he's okay. I think it's more out of frustration he didn't land it.
Smooth rail section, holds it for the whole time.
Just say he's given the thumbs up in the finish area, so he is okay.
Going off axis that time. Trying to land it, switch. Not an easy thing to do, especially off the last money boot that's so big here in Sopka.
No, it didn't stick any run in the final, sadly, for Kuznetsov. And he's gutted, you can see. Fist pump for the start judge, and he'll go skiers left for that rainbow feature.
Rider's struggling with that right side feature as well. Just chips off, spins off the back of it. It's really nice start. Has to check the speed to come and switch to the down rail.
Yelaika's going to get a little tap again. There he is, a double tap on the rotation as well. Schmidhalter coming in switch. And a 720 off the first kicker.
Not going as big as others, but it's a good clean run so far.
That's Montar! It was so close to 14.40.
Four rotations for a 14.40.
He did it, he got there, but he couldn't stop the landing.
Knew what was coming. Went super consistent on the rails. Went for the 7 in transition to take off the booter. That would have been close. Not been here for the whole competition, but that would have been close.
It was very, very close. That's the first 7.20. Have a look at this as he revs up. Well, we won't see the whole rotation, but he's spinning so quickly and he gets there. Oh, he just can't quite stick it.
Holds a grab forever as well.
So Elliot Gollet of France is guaranteed a medal. So the final results of the men's ski slopestyle final. Tobias Müller of Germany takes the gold with his first run. Elliot Gollet of France couldn't improve after his first run, nor could Jonas Schmidhalter of Switzerland as they round off the podium. Well, it's been an epic afternoon of slopestyle here at the Sopka Cluster. We hope you've enjoyed all the action from Krasnoyarsk 2019. Thanks for your company.